Hello everyone, I am Leonardo Lanzi, the coordinator of the GARD Cybersecurity Team. This small talk is about ICT security policy.
I guess what you are thinking now. Do we really need more rules? So, let's see. First of all, we need to know where our threats come from. Because only in a perfect, ideal and boring world, there are no security risks. If you just agreed, you could also accept that each institution should write its own ICT security policy, based on some realistic targets and on an honest evaluation of resources. At the end, you will have a mix of rules and procedures, a sort of guiding light in the darkness of the cyber threats, or a good approximation of it. We will analyze some examples of security policies. Then, you will be ready to start again the process, considering that security should possibly evolve as fast as threats do. Our daily life is already following several policies, and I'm sure that you know what to do in the following cases: during lessons, where to throw away what, when you hear the fire alarm, in case of earthquake or flood alert, maybe even when danger comes from outside our planet. Even ICT security risks must be managed. They concern both the external world we constantly browse, the internet, but also our small world, especially how we are used to deal with computers and personal devices. Just to give an example, probably the most critical security problem is due to passwords, especially if you find yours in this picture. Usually, potential issues are located in the middle. Dark guy with a sweatshirt. Only 3 years ago, a survey in the USA showed that near 90% of hundreds of CEOs was extremely concerned about cyber threats. But less than 30% knew something about overall security strategy, budget, policies and technologies. And even less did a review of security and privacy risks, roles and responsibilities. Our aim is to keep safe systems, information, each student or teacher, the school as a whole. Each school group will have a specific policy. Therefore, during its formulation, the ICT team should consult management, teachers, administrative staff, and students. Policy must be realistic and feasible to carry out, concise, and easily understood by users. A balance between protection and productivity. Security measures don't have to obstruct the institutional work of the users. Regarding the contents, the ICT security policy should include at least aims of the policy, rules, guidelines and procedures, incident handling and identification of responsible persons, usage and responsibility definitions for different user groups, violation handling and enforcement. The success of a school ICT security policy relies on its user security awareness and willingness to comply with the policy's terms. Given the rising level of risks seen recently, it is more critical than ever that organizations raise security awareness and turn users into a first line of defense. Awareness training could be provided with a different level of complexity for different kinds of users, while rules, guidelines, and procedures should be published and delivered to the right user groups. A culture of security awareness should be built into any deployment plan, ensuring that users understand their ICT security responsibilities, and the persistent maintenance program put in place to ensure continuous awareness. The application of the policy is the key and longest phase in the whole life cycle of the ICT security program, when everyone knows their responsibilities, and policy, rules and guidelines are fully implemented. Each group monitors the compliance of regular activities with the policy. Any violation is reported and managed. Schools should continuously monitor ICT security policy conformance. Threats are always evolving, hence auditing should identify inefficient parts that may require enhancement or updating. Such evaluation will be possible only if security requirements documentation and incident reports are both provided. Security policy must be considered as a life cycle process. We introduce two examples of acceptable use policy. Consider that each user should sign it, accepting the basic rules that he or she will find inside. Student AUP should state something like that. ICT resources are for official use. Your internet and computer activity should be logged. Be careful when you use your data, and even more if you share them. Don't play video games, don't download illegal contents. And don't be tempted by the dark side of the hacking. Trust the source of everything before to open: email, internet sites, software or applications for smart devices. Bad contents or activities must be reported to the staff or to teachers. You have to apply the same rules also for teachers, administrative and technical staff, and don't forget parents. But a special attention must be addressed to students' activities. After practicing with ICT security, you will add a secure attitude to your personality traits. You will act securely without thinking about it. And in some cases, it will be necessary to break some rules, to face the unexpected, or to find new ways to manage ICT security.